Hello everyone and welcome to a new edition of Women's World. Today, as you may notice, we are celebrating Ramadan. This is the first edition of the program in the holy month of Ramadan. And during the holy month, we will be presenting you four special editions of the program when it comes to the topics we'll be discussing with you, when it comes to the decoration here in the studio. Everything is going to be different. So let me start by extending my congratulations to Muslims around the world, marking the holy month of Ramadan. Ramadan in Egypt has a very special flavor. And if you are not in Egypt, you have to come down here and see how Egyptians celebrate the holy month of Ramadan when it comes to the traditions, hanging the lanterns or the fanous, eating certain types of foods or desserts. Everything you need to know about Ramadan we'll be telling you later. But now let me tell you a little bit about what you will be watching in this edition of the program. Today I will be presenting to you or introducing to you two Egyptian artists, Manar Salah and Asma El Mahdi, and they are two very talented young Egyptian girls. They have their own work and they collaborated together to present to us some masterpieces of art. Also, we'll be watching a special report about iftar around the world. This is coming up next. And after that, you will be meeting with Manar and Asma. Stay with us.
So much peace fills up the air. Ramadan, month of the Quran, I feel it inside me, strengthening my iman. But how I wish you'd be here with me all year around.
Welcome back. It's time now to introduce you to my dear guest today, Manar Salah. She is an artist. She is an artist of mosaic and stained glass. And also Asma' al-Mahdi, she is an artist who makes masterpieces using copper. We're going to watch their profile, then we'll be right back. Stay with us. Welcome back. في البداية بحب أرحب بيكو منار صلاح مصممة مهندسة تصميمات لفن المزيك. أهلا بيكي. وأسماء المهدي مصممة فن تشكيلي
نحيل. Many happy returns. Thank you. Many happy returns to you too. Our episode today would be a special episode because we want the episodes in the holy month of Ramadan to be a bit different and to have to do with Egyptian, Oriental, Islamic arts celebrating the month of Ramadan. So the episodes would be different. When we saw your pieces, we wanted to know more about you. So I would like to start first by asking about your studies. I'll start with you, Manar. What did you study?
I'm a bachelor's degree of Faculty of Fine Arts. Mosaic is, during the past 2 years, is the field that I was working on, and I have started working on it since I was in the university. And we started designing a lot of accessories, I along with Asma. And then I said, after going to the Egyptian market, that there are a lot of Chinese pieces. So we wanted to show the Egyptian pieces. So mosaic for me is like the stained glass. But people up till now do not understand what is mosaic. Mosaic, it's a material. It's exported. Here it is like small tiles, and it has two types, transparent tiles and a bit solid ones like this one. Can we see it? Yes. These are the transparent glittery ones, like the ones I used here on this lantern. And here, these are the ones that do not give any shine. And those are imported. So I try to use it like the stained glass by the same manner. I've selected the colors, and I've used it on things, old pieces like the lanterns. I will talk about the irradiance, but I would like to first ask Asma, you are graduated from the Faculty of Fine Arts? No, I'm graduated from the Faculty of Social Studies, Helwan University. It started with me as a talent. I was designing things for myself first, things to be in my house, and things that I used to wear, and my friends and family used to encourage me to design more things. So I started along with Manar to design and make pieces together. It was as a talent first, and afterwards when people appreciated our works, we started introducing new materials and designing and making new accessories. After it, Manar started working on mosaic and I on copper. How did you get to know each other? We are relatives. We are cousins, and we were brought up together. When did you have the idea of working together? Each artist wants to make his work alone, because in every piece he makes, he puts in it his ideas, his feelings and emotions. So the idea of both of you making one piece in which you collect both your talents, when did it start? I started the mosaic project. When I started making mosaic, and Asma started making the copper trees, because we have used the copper in the jewelry in the beginning, I said to Asma, let's do a different thing. Let's put both our works together. By this, we will have a distinguished piece, and it would be different from what is there in the market, because there are people who make the copper trees and others who make the mosaic, but putting them together would be a new thing, and it would make different pieces. Asma, you like the idea of making a piece with someone, or did you want to have your own work on your own? This is not a rule. Sometimes we work on pieces together, and I work on pieces on my own. But when we work together, you add new ideas, and we give new ideas. It gives you a wider space to produce, to design. So we select the designs together. Instead of having only one idea, we put our ideas together, so we have a number of ideas before us, and we select the best of them. And also sometimes she makes pieces on her own, I make pieces on my own, but I think that the mix between my work and her is the new thing about us. Manar, you talked about a very important thing, and it is the idea of preserving the Egyptian heritage and the Egyptian arts. And this is something that we are all upset about, because when we go to Khan al-Khalili, we find a lot of Chinese products that are cheap. Buy them, and the finishing is bad. Yes, a very bad quality, as they say. And they are cheap, and people buy it. When I went to Morocco, for example, I found that they have preserved all their arts and their handicrafts, be it in the galabeas, the handmade products. They have protected them from any invasion from abroad, especially the Chinese products. And they cherish their products, and they protect their market. This is something I wanted to talk to you about. Now, when you found the Chinese products there in the market, you decided to do something different, the Egyptian things. Yes, this is what motivated me. I've been graduated for a long time from the faculty, and I did not do this work before. I've started just producing things for my house, but afterwards, when I saw the Chinese market in Chinese products in the market, I started saying, why don't we produce our products? Maybe it is a problem of marketing. As for Egypt, they are not very much interested in this, because any field or any part in the product is not taken into consideration. They think of just importing the products, but now there started to appear the culture of handmade products. This is what we want to happen right now, to focus more on handmade products so that people would appreciate them, so that they would understand, even if it is expensive, it's expensive because it's handmade, it passes through a number of stages, and it uses a lot of materials. If you would go into any gallery, you will find that all the products are important, and we can do things similar and better than these pieces, and they can also have more work, and you would be able to put all your efforts in it, as they say that it would be a high technology piece. I would like to talk to me more about your products, because we have some of your pieces here. Can you show me some of your pieces and tell me the stages of this piece, and since designing up till the final product, what are the tools, the materials used, and how do you select the colors? I start first by talking about the tools I use. You know, of course, the copper wire, and there are several thicknesses for the copper wires. There are three colors: gold, silver, and the brown, or oxide. And there are different thicknesses. This is 3 mils. This is 1 mili. So there are several sizes and thicknesses, and this is a copper cylinder. I cut this copper cylinder, and I use it, for example, in this lantern. I made this lantern by this, and also this lamp over there. These are coins that I have cut from this cylinder, and I cover them by the applique art pieces, and I put it on the lamp. As for the colors, I like very much to put the different colors together, because it gives people the feeling of relaxation. You are using shiny colors, the yellow, the green, the blue, and the red. Yes, we have tried to use the collection of the colors of Ramadan. We use a lot of colors, and it depends on, of course, the apartment. If your apartment is classic, different colors are used, but other colors are to be used for the modern houses and modern furniture. In the collection of Ramadan, we try to use shiny colors, the colors of the applique art, like, for example, this lantern. This is made from the copper wires, and this was the first design I made for the lanterns. The design of the lantern is a bit different because there are spaces. We are not used to this. We are used to the closed lanterns, to have this, and for me to see the back and the front and the lamp inside the lantern is the new thing. Yes, this is what distinguishes the handmade designs, is that we are able to design things. And of course, since they stopped the importation of lanterns, this gave us the opportunity to produce different lanterns. I used here copper cylinders, and I used marbles with different colors, and I used also crochet with crystal beads. And here there is a door to be opened and closed so that you would be able to put a candle, a lamp, whatever you want to use. Can you put it in front of the camera so that people would be able to see the door? Yes, here's the door, and you can put it here to close it. And I can put whatever I want. How much time did you need to make this lantern? It was the first lantern I made, so it took me 4 days. Most of our products were sold, thank God. As for this lantern, I made this lantern yesterday. I wanted to finish it in one day in order to bring it. You here, I have used tulle along with the copper, the ribbons, and we have introduced here new colors, new materials to change the shape of the lantern. Manar, would you please talk to me about your pieces? I have only one lantern. It is this one. But all the other lanterns were shown in the profile. I liked this shape because it is an Arab art. This is old Egypt. And this is what is there in the mosques, yes. And it is basically used to be hanging from the ceiling. But here I try to use it in different way. I try to use color similar to the colors of the applique art. And for the mosaic, it is broken. So you break it into pieces like glass. You break it into smaller pieces. For example, here there are different directions, things horizontal, others vertical, smaller squares and bigger ones. So it takes a day for this piece to be finished. And afterwards, I cover it. First, we use the white glue. You stick them beside each other. Yes, all those mirror pieces are put beside each other, and I stick them by the white glue. And you should, of course, have the design in your mind, because a lot of people can use it, but it differs from one person to the other according to his style. After I stick it, it takes a day, and after next day, I start to clean it from the glue, because, of course, there is glue on the glass. And afterwards, I use the lip powder. It's a white powder, and I can change the color of this powder. I prefer using the black one, so I add to it the black color, and I start putting it over the piece and start assembling the piece. When I use the collection of a special color, I try to do a collection, like you can see here, for example, cups, so that it would be like a set, yes, a cup match with the lantern, because people might want to take a whole group. And these two cups, can you show them? Here you can see a mixture between mosaic and glass. This is not just the mosaic. The red pieces are glass, and it's imported. All the materials we use are imported. Why don't we have these materials? It's glass. Yes, but the type of glass we have is the green, the blue, and the transparent. But as for the American glass, there are different types of glass. And the piece inside the piece of glass, you will find different colors as if it is a piece of cloth. For example, if we're talking about a violet piece, you will find violet, light violet with dark violet. And the mosaic is also imported. We hope it would be made here. So in this piece, there is a mixture between the mosaic and the pieces of glass. The same applies to this cup. And here also you can see the salt. I've covered it with the applique art. These pieces are in glass. This is mosaic. The material is glass because for on the mosaic is easily being stuck on glass or wood. Can we see it? Explain to me while we see it. You can see here that it is made of glass and I've put mosaic on it and there is another shape. Shouldn't we have both one for salt and one for pepper? I intended to do both, but after it took the mosaic, it took a bigger space, so I had to make another piece in a different way. This is a glass plate on it, which I put the applique art, and also you can change the things. Once you have an idea and you want to design and to do something different in your house, here you have two pieces that look differently, and they look nice if you are inviting people for dinner. To talk about my work along with Asma, this plate. This is a very normal plate. I brought the applique art cloth, and I have put it here, and the design is a bit different. I brought decoupage. Decoupage is the art of cutting papers, but instead of cutting papers, I used cutting cloth. Yes, this is what I did, and this is a new idea to put cloth with the mosaic, and it's a nice idea. I've noticed that the mosaic colors you used are the same colors of the applique art cloth. Yes, you need to select the colors so that people would feel that they are all mosaic and that not that a part of it is cloth. I would like to know more from you about your products. Of course, you need to go to workshops and you need to work with different workers and you need to finish pieces and others would complete them for you. Would you tell us more about this? Of course, we were at home not doing anything and all of a sudden we went to a lot of workshops and we started working with workers. It is not an easy job to finish the work with the workers but we work with good people who finish these things easy for us. Do you work in a team? Do you divide your duties and jobs among us? For example, you go to the workshop and I'm going to sell the pieces. In the beginning, we went used to make accessories, we used to go together. As for the mosaic, Manar bring it, I bring the copper, and we go to the applique art workshops to bring it. We've selected first, of course, the designs we are going to work on, and we tried as much as we can to make a different thing to be presented in the collection of Ramadan. So first we have put the designs we are going to work on, and afterwards we went and bought the materials we are going to use together. And since we're talking about the workshops, one of the things that we did is this crescent. This was an idea, a new idea to us, so that there would be a mix between my work and Manar's. We've selected two symbols from Ramadan, the star, the lantern, the crescent. Unfortunately, we do not have more time, but many happy returns. And it is so nice to see two young Egyptian girls working and producing handmade Egyptian products, marketing and selling them. Thank you, and many happy returns. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for being with us in this edition of Women's World. Happy Ramadan to all of you. We'll be meeting you again next week, same time. Till then.